Hi folks, so today I'm going to try something new. I apologize for the audio quality and possibly even the video quality as well. I'm actually shooting this on my new phone. This is a second-hand, I'm just going to read it over here, Samsung Galaxy J5. So I don't think it's particularly the newest phone. I just got a good deal on a second-hand phone. So I thought I might just try out the sound and everything in this echoey office, I know. But I actually wanted to do a bit of a channel update as well. I'm probably going to talk a little bit about this phone on the next Trendy Talk. If you don't know what Trendy Talk is, then it is a podcast that I'm on with HexDSL and Drew, also known as Uo. So that's definitely worth checking out. And to be honest, if you're looking for like more of my content these days, that tends to be where it is. We tend to shoot most weeks, but we try and aim for at least every other week. But we're not a scheduled podcast. We're keeping it pretty easy going, because when you do podcasts, like things like scheduling and planning and all this kind of stuff really drain the fun out of doing them, so we're just going to wing it. But no, the big channel update is that I have closed my gaming channel, and I'm going to be focusing on free and open source software games, FOSS games, and they're going to be put onto this channel. So over the next couple of weeks, you're probably going to be seeing more than usual levels of gaming content. That's simply because some of the best content from the gaming channel is going to be shifted over here. It's all going to be free and open source gaming stuff. I am including OpenMW in that, which is the open source engine for Morrowind. It's a re-implementation, and things like OpenTTD, as well as, of course, Battle for Wesnoth. I played Battle for Wesnoth with Hamish last night. For those of you that don't know, Hamish is he Twitch streams on, he is Hamish TBP, Hamish the Polar Bear, and he streams on Twitch. He streams from Linux. I think he's using Manjaro or Arch, depending on which machine he's using. And I beat him for the first time in like forever, and it's amazing. So that was great, and he was undead, and he's great when he's undead. But anyway, Battle for Wesnoth, that will definitely be featuring on this channel, because that is just one of the best turn-based strategy games I've ever played. But yeah, I kind of got a little bit, I kind of felt like there was this need for a new type of content on, like a new change of pace, basically. Having two channels is a lot of work to administer, and I'm not putting out that much gaming content. And towards the end of it, the gaming content I was putting out was, like, I was like having to schedule it in and push stuff that I didn't want to push out just so that I could record gaming content, and I don't want to do that. So it's going to be a little bit easier for me just to administrate one channel. As well as the fact that, like, you know, I'm not going to be putting out a ton of gaming content, and I want to focus on open source games, because that's a space that I really like. I remember back in the early days of Linux gaming, when a game used to come out for Linux, it used to be like an event. Like, everyone that used to be interested in gaming on Linux used to like pick up this game and play it. And then Steam came along, and in the early days of Steam, that was still a thing, you know, where we really enjoyed new games that came along. But now there are new games being released every day, and thanks to Proton and things like GeForce Now, and I suppose Google Stadia, you know, gaming on Linux is really not that much different to gaming on Windows. Like 90% of the games you can play on Windows, you can play on Linux now pretty much just as well. And if you can't find a game that you like, you know, on Linux, then, you know, you're fussy. You know, that's the long short of it. You've got a weirdly specific taste in games. If you know, the only games that really struggle when it comes to Linux is like AAA multiplayer games. That's really what it comes down to, and it's huge levels of DRM and that kind of stuff that kind of make it a bit tricky in that regard. But yeah, so there will be some gaming content that's coming onto this channel from the old one. Also, for those of you that don't know, I do have another project. I do have another channel that I run with friends. A lot of gaming content is on that. It's called Project Chronicle, and that is going to sort of be what you might consider my de facto second channel, where I just muck around with friends and all that kind of stuff. And that's really good that's been around since 2013, I think it has. So that's a pretty old channel. And there's loads of content on that. Some of my favorite content that I've ever put out on the internet is on that channel, including things like Gary's Mod. Me playing Gary's Mod with friends, those are like really happy memories. But yeah, I'm really now as my schedule is pretty busy coming, you know, bouncing back from the pandemic and everything, I'm trying to be a little bit more careful about where I place my time. Obviously, I want a good balance between work time and leisure time, everyone does. But when it comes to leisure time, I want to focus on playing games that I have a deeper connection with. I know that open source games are not exactly going to be the same fidelity as AAA games. That's not their point. That's like comparing, you know, a Village Fate to a Greggs. Like, you know, they're different. They serve different purposes despite both providing baked goods, you know. So that's a very British reference, by the way. Don't worry if to my American friends if you don't get that. But it's like, you know, you don't compare your independent bookstore to Amazon, for example. Your independent bookstore isn't going to be able to get you any book that's ever been written on your doorstep the same or the next day. That's just, you know, you don't go to your independent bookstores for the same kind of service you get from Amazon. So I'm going to definitely be enjoying making content for this channel again back in the future. Sorry that I've been a little bit on the quiet side, but, you know, a lot of changes going around these days, and you know, we're all trying to adapt and learn and that kind of stuff. In terms of this new phone, interesting new phone. It's a Samsung Galaxy J5. I don't know what that means, but I see a lot of people very happy with Samsung phones. When I installed it, it seemed like there was this weird battle going on inside the phone between the Samsung suite of tools and the Google stuff. And there was even some like Microsoft stuff that came pre-installed with it, which was weird. And I just ended up removing a lot of the stuff that came out of the box. Like it seemed like, oh, do you want to use the Samsung tools? Do you want to use the Google tools? And it seemed like, yeah, Google and Samsung were like fighting over control of over the phone, which was kind of weird. And not a great, and you know, sort of end user experience for me. And considering that I'm used to, my last phone was just stock Android. It's okay. It's good. It's a quality phone. The camera looks kind of all right. Looks better. I hope the sound looks better. It's the sound that I'm more worried about than anything else. But I mean, this is second hand, and it cost me about the same as my old phone did first hand. So I guess this is maybe a bit of an upgrade. Who knows? But thank you folks very much for joining me for a nice little ramble. I hope the sound quality is not terrible. But yeah, thank you very much for watching. If you are not a fan of the gaming content, I'm going to make it clear from the thumbnails that it is gaming content and all that kind of stuff. It may be a little bit more commonplace over the next few weeks as I bring stuff over, but it will trail off over then. And I'm going to try and keep it furnished with also a variety of content as well. But yeah, I'm going to be like sort of taking a slightly less formal approach to this channel because it's, you know, like it's, you know, I'm sort of returning to its hobby state where it's a bit more authentic and a bit more off the cuff, I guess it is. And it has been that way for a while, but now I'm just sort of, you know, I'm just going to continue to sort of embrace that, I guess. But thank you folks very much for joining me. And yeah, don't forget to check out Trendy Talk. It's on Hex's channel, youtube.com/HexDSL. It's also available on Gemini. It's linked through my Gemini capsule, gem.chrisware.uk. But you need, of course, a Gemini browser for that. And it's on PeerTube as well. So yeah, if you are following me in the Fediverse, you should probably already know about my PeerTube channel. But failing that, if you don't know, ask me on Mastodon. It's fine. Great. Anyway, thank you folks very much for joining me. My arm is kind of aching now from holding this phone like this far away from me. It's kind of interesting. So I'm going to put it down, I guess. But thank you very much for joining me. Pleasure as always. And until next time, I've been Chris Ware, and you've been awesome. Toodaloo.